Hello, this is Eric. LBGR's official UI Editor Scaleline Studio finally has been released. In the previous beta version, it was named Edgeline, but it seems to have been renewed by changing the price plan and license policy. From this video, I'm gonna make a tutorial for Scaleline Studio. One of the quickest ways to run UI tools is to create designs that have already been made in your own way. Since I was developing mobile applications, I have learned so many tools in this way. As you can see on the screen, currently when you visit the Tesla website, you can see this page. In the first tutorial, we start with the easiest one. I will show you how I draw it in Scaleline Studio with a few widgets. Also, I will export it as C code so that ES32 can draw it on the screen. Visit Scaleline.io to download the program. I downloaded this program on Windows because it's not yet supported for Mac. I hope it supports Mac as soon as possible. If you look at the price plan, it's quite aggressive. For personal use, you have to pay $9 per month, which is even a promotional price. I think the price is very high for those who develop it as a hobby. I'm not sure if I keep using Scaleline Studio because of the expensive price plan, but let's get started. After downloading, unzip and install it. There's nothing special, so let's move fast. Let me open the Scaleline Studio. When you run it, it shows the remaining days because I'm currently using the trial version. You can see the menu has open, create, and example. If you look at the example menu, there are several pre-loaded examples. There are well-made examples, so please give it a try. It will be helpful. In the create menu, in the lower right corner, you can create a new project through project setting. Please enter the name of the project you want and the resolution of the display you have. I'm gonna use the ST7796 display and it works in a 3.5-inch display or 480x320. Color depth is set to 16-bit. ES32 use 16-bits instead of the 32-bit. For the theme, you can select the desired one. One screen came up. This is a screen you can add any widget you need to it. The first thing to do is to add the background image you will use. You can add images for use within the project via the Add File into Assets button below. I prepared the background image file that fits 480x320. I was able to get the original image from the gallery on the Tesla website officially. This is a screen I will make. To keep things very simple today, let's create a Model 3 header title, subtitle, and two buttons below. Drag and drop the image to the screen, name it background image. It's convenient to use a tool such as a color picker to easily see the color code of an image. First, let's create a button below. Double click the button in the widgets tab in the row left to automatically add the widget to the screen. Rename the button to button custom order. You can easily get the RGB values of a specific part of the image through the color picker on the right screen. The RGB values of the background color of this button are 55, 60, 65, so let's set them the same. The button seems to be too large. Let's change the height to 24 pixels and the width to 160 pixels. We use a label widget to put a label inside the button. If you look at the hierarchy structure on the left, you can see the, how the screen is organized. If you select a label and put it in a button, the button becomes a parent and the label becomes a child. Now change the text of the label. Enter custom order. You need to change the font size. I think 1/10 would be good. The custom order button is done. To arrange the two buttons neatly, I'm using a panel to organize them. I have created one panel widget at the bottom. The width is the 400 pixel and the height is 50 pixel. Set align to bottom middle. Set -20 on the Y position to give margins at the bottom. Drag the custom order button and put it on the bottom panel. After that, click the widget copy icon to create one identical button from the custom order button. Name this button existing inventory. Select the custom order button again, change the align to left middle. This time, select the existing inventory button, change align to right middle. Both buttons should be equally spaced from the center of the bottom panel. You can see that the button has the X position set to -30. Need to be set to 0. Now the buttons looks good. Let's fix the existing inventory button. First change the name on the label. The text color and background color should be set in reverse. I will set the background color of the button to white and the color of the text to black. The background color of the bottom panel should not be there, so adjust the alpha value to make it transparent. Also change the alpha value of the border color to 0 to make it transparent. This completes the raw part of the screen. Now all that's left is to put the header title and subtitle. Simply use the label widget to add them. The font size of the header title will be Montserrat 20. Be sure to remember the font used here. I only used Montserrat 10 and 20 in this project. You need to enable the font you used in your project through AirVisual config header file. I will show you it again later. You can easily insert text using the label widget. I will quickly complete the subtitle part below. When the screen is complete, you can simulate it through the play button. We didn't any special events in this project, so no events occur. A gray UI screen was completed very easily. You can save it as a C file through export on the top menu. Select file to extract only C files. Selecting project exports everything including LVGL. This is not required on ESP32. On the screen to save, you need to create a folder. Perhaps this part will be improved in the next version. If you select a folder like this, it will output as C files. Not only widgets but also images are all changed by code, so it's very easy to use in ESP32. With this code we get from SquareRine Studio, let's display the screen on the device. Let's go to the Arduino IDE. The version of LVGL is 8.2.0. If it's not yet the latest version, please update it. Settings, the graphics driver, and LVGL 8 on ESP32 have already been shown in the previous project. If you need this part, please refer to my video. You can find the link below. This code is to run the LVGL 8 demo using the ESP32 Raspberry Pi device. I will proceed based on this code. Select and copy and paste the entire code. TFT ESPi, Raviang GFX are both great. You can use the graphics driver you like. I'm using Raviang GFX in this project. Remove unnecessary parts first. Okay, this is the minimal code to get started with LVGL 8 on ESP32. Copy of files obtained from SquareRine Studio to the current project folder. You can see that 5 files have been added. If you press Command E in the Arduino IDE, you can see the files in the folder you are currently working on. On Windows, this is the Control E. Modify the path of the LVGL in the UI header file and UI helpers header file. Please note this part may be different depending on the path of the LVGL. You need to open the LV config header file to enable the font used in this screen. Montserrat 10 and 20 must be enabled so that an error does not occur. Back to the code, import UI header file and just call the UI init function at the end of the setup function. This way, we can show the screen we worked on in SquareRine Studio on the ESP32. It was built and uploaded without any problems. The screen created in SquareRine Studio is being output in the same way on ESP32. It's great. It's possible to create a high quality GUI because it's really simple to work with. Creating a UI with a code takes a lot of time due to trial and error. Also, this can reduce productivity. In this video, we covered the very basics. I'd like to be able to create a more difficult UI based on this. Thank you for watching. See you on the next video.